today I have my husband here with me. I asked you guys on Instagram to leave questions regarding our wedding so we could do like a wedding Q&A, and he decided to be in it with me, which was so nice of him because if you haven't noticed, he hates being on camera, so he's not an asshole, he just doesn't like this. Ready? Let's go. What flavor was the cake? Vanilla and then raspberry. What is your number one glam tip for the day of? To carry your lipstick around with you. What about your relationship reminds you of Jim and Pam, and what made you guys want to include that in your wedding?
And most of all, never stop being your best friend and lover, just like Jim and Pam from The Office. You can always count on me, I love you.
Jim and Pam and you and me started out just friends.
Yeah, we were like dating other people like they were too, so yeah. How did you know B was the one?
When you could be yourself around the person you just know.
The shark guy, it was a shark, right? Someone wants us to explain this costume that our friend was wearing. It was actually a caterpillar.
One of my best friends and groomsman, Ray, he wore a caterpillar suit to our Halloween party that we threw. He said, I'm gonna wear it to the wedding. And of course, I said, you won't. And he did, and it was awesome.
He just wore it for like when you announced the bridal party at the reception. He did not wear that during the ceremony. I would kill him. Did you and Matt look at rings before I proposed?
We kind of did, because you would go into, specifically Costco, straight to the ring section, and it would be one of those games like, which one do you think I would choose?
Yeah. You learned by what I didn't like, which is a lot of things that I don't like. I'm very picky. Matt, how awesome is it having the Star Wars theme being played at your wedding?
Awesome.
Our string quartet played the Star Wars theme song when we had our first kiss and like left our ceremony. It was pretty funny. What is your favorite thing about each other? Matt always makes me laugh like every day. It's just painful. So that's probably my favorite thing.
Everything is, I think we can both be ourselves and have fun with each other.
Yeah.
Like last night we played Pokemon Snap.
Yeah, we are so weird. I think if people like watched us, it would be so scary.
I promise to never lose sight of our quirky young selves, to keep talking in our own made up languages, keep singing our stupid songs, and keep kicking your butt in Mario Party.
I promise to stay young at heart and try to make you laugh. I promise to cook you your two favorite foods, chicken nuggets and fettuccine. I promise to love your Star Wars collection as long as it's confined to one room in the house.
How did you feel when you first saw Brianna in her wedding dress?
So many emotions. I don't think there's one specific word, because I didn't know what she looked like because the whole dress thing was a big surprise. She never showed me pictures or anything, so I didn't know what to expect. Pretty emotional time turning around and being like, oh, this is it. This is you.
Is there anything you would change about the wedding? Unrealistically, I would like if it were longer, but it just went by so fast. If it could be like an all day reception, that would be nice. But that's
it was
not
probably fine for everyone else, but for us, it went by like that.
Yeah, believe it when they tell you your wedding day will go by fast, because it'll be over. My fiance and I need to start planning our wedding. Where do you begin? I would suggest going to a bridal expo. They have them in January and June, I think. That's very helpful.
Get one of those checklists from the Knot or whatever.
Oh yeah, sign up for the Knot and then they'll tell you what you need to do like 6 months out, 9 months out, 3 months out, whatever. What did you appreciate most from your bridesmaids? How were they helpful? I think they were just really supportive and some parts of the wedding planning process and just like things that don't go right, they were very supportive. They calmed me down. How did you end up having a Say Yes to the Dress episode? I decided to do Say Yes to the Dress because I had watched the show forever and I loved it. I already knew I wanted to go to Kleinfeld for my dress, and when they found out that I was going, they wanted me to blog about it. And then we just kind of decided to do the Say Yes to the Dress episode instead. Any downsides to a large wedding party? No, I don't think ours was that large. I know people who have had like 11 bridesmaids. I think trying to wrangle a group of dudes is harder to do than the girls. Like, they do not listen. Remember the rehearsal, like, walkthrough? It was like literally, hello! Pay attention! What was the theme of your wedding? Matt, don't be shy. We'd love to hear your perspective.
Rustic, modern-esque. The colors were neutral, like grays and khakis, tans, mm-hmm. burlap.
White,
yeah.
Our flowers were all white, and we had like green succulents. Writing vows that don't sound cliche. Our officiant, Matt Nathanson, you should check him out if you are in the Phoenix area. He's amazing. He helped us write our vows and like, he did it separately. So he'd email Matt and he'd email me and then kind of tell us what to do.
Look online to get ideas of how people sometimes do it, but then make your own.
It was basically just memories and like
we put together a story,
about each other.
I was lucky enough just to crush on you years ago. At Michael's party. Now I'm the luckiest guy in the world to be marrying you and call you my wife. I promise to keep encouraging you, following your dreams, because you could do anything you put your mind to, and through that, you inspired me to be hardworking and as inspired as you are. By default, you are now a Rangers fan and Giants fan. So I appreciate you living with my obsessions and becoming part of them. For that, I owe you those head massages you constantly want.
I knew that night we were going to jump into something big. I can't believe I'm standing here with you about to become your wife. I can't believe you picked me. I promise to support you no matter where you are in the world and no matter how much time separates us. I promise to never take you for granted. You are my always and forever.
What inspired you to make the origami backdrop DIY? So for those of you who don't know, I wanted like origami hanging behind us. And so I folded 1,000 origami cranes, because if you fold 1,000, then you're granted a wish, and origamis in general are good for good luck. That is disgusting. Disgusting. Okay. Ooh, people asked about Say Yes to the Dress episode. Not yet. It is not out yet. It is probably going to be next season. Did Matt cry when you walked down the aisle?
I already saw her at first look, and that was an emotional time, so I think that kind of spared me from being emotional when she walked down.
Who walked you down the aisle? I walked myself down the aisle like this. Where was your venue? We got married at Blackstone Country Club, and it was beautiful. Was it embarrassing when you ripped your pants?
I tore a small hole in my knee because I did a slide.
It was not a small hole.
It's a small hole.
It was a slip. Is marriage everything you hoped it would be?
I say the same thing to everyone. Same thing, same thing, same thing.
Same thing.
I say the same thing.
Same thing.
To everyone. Life is the exact same, and it should be.
Yeah.
I don't think anything should change, or you shouldn't have to act a certain way.
We already lived together. I know a lot of people don't live together before they get married or whatever. We were already bumping and grinding.
Really going there?
Oh, what songs were on your playlist? That's a good one.
We mixed in a lot of like Golding, I Alaska, Band of Horses, like Bruno Mars.
DMX. What type of dress were you wearing? I wore Lazaro. I have been wanting to wear his dresses since I was, I don't even know, forever.
Me too.
So that is the end of our wedding Q&A. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys liked seeing this, oh, we have to do this because we forgot. My sister, during her maid of honor speech, gave us matching pairs of blue shorts. Why don't you show them what you're wearing right now?
Yeah, boy.